Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 55th video class of DIP, we will study opening and closing in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. We are learning different morphological image processing techniques, and opening and closing are advanced morphological image processing techniques. Starting with the name, why this technique is called opening? It is called opening because it can open up a gap between objects connected by thin bridge of pixels. And why closing technique is called closing? It is called closing because it can fill holes or close holes or gaps in the regions while keeping the initial region sizes. So let us start. Starting with the slide that we saw in the previous video class of different morphological operations, erosion is given by A minus of B and minus is in circle, while dilation is given by A plus of B. Why? Because we are adding the pixels over here and here we are removing or subtracting the pixels. Opening is denoted by a open circle and is given by A opening of B is equal to A erosion of B whole dilation of B. Conversely, closing is given by a filled closed circle and is denoted by A closing of B is equal to A dilation of B whole erosion of B, where B is our structuring element. So together with closing, opening serves as a basic technique for morphological noise removal. Opening removes small objects from the foreground, that is smooth with respect to object, which are usually taken as bright pixels of an image, placing them in the background, while closing or closening removes small holes in the foreground, changing small islands of background into foreground, that is smooth with respect to background. So if this is the image and we want to carry out opening for this, then first we will do erosion, that is A minus of B, A minus of B. So erosion will remove this bridge, okay, and we will get the object like this, and afterwards we carry out dilation of this so that these structures are smoothened out while general shape is also preserved. For closing, we first do the dilation. So dilation will result in such a image. So here we can see that the gaps are filled, and afterwards we carry out erosion and again smoothing is obtained and general shape is also preserved. So this opening is similar to erosion but is less destructive, we can say, and we get the noise removal. And closing is similar to dilation and is also less destructive. So how to remember the opening and closing? So for opening, you can remember like this: erosion E followed by dilation D will give opening O, EDO, EDO. And for closing, we can remember like this: dilation D followed by erosion E will give closing C, that is deck, right? Let's go ahead. Opening and closing are two important morphological operations. Opening smooths the contour or boundary of an object, breaks narrow isthmuses or narrow strips, you can say, and eliminates thin protrusions or bulge or bumps. So it breaks narrow strips and eliminates thin bulges. This is a narrow strip that is broken by opening, and it also eliminates thin bulges. Okay, so these are the bulges which are eliminated in opening. While closing joins narrow breaks. So this is a narrow break that is joined by closing. Opening is generally used to restore or recover the original image to the maximum possible extent. Closing is generally used to smoother the contour of the distorted image and fuse back the narrow breaks and long thin gulfs. Closing is also used for getting rid of the small holes of the obtained image. Let us first understand opening. Opening of a set A by structuring element B is defined as A opening of B is equal to A erosion of B whole dilation of B, that is erosion followed by dilation. The opening operation is used to remove regions of an object that cannot contain the structuring element, you can say, that are smaller than the structuring element, smooth boundaries and break thin connections. So if this is the image, the result of opening by using 5 cross 5 square structuring element is like this, where these all lines are removed, whereas the result of using 9 cross 9 square structuring element will remove even these thicker lines and only these objects will remain. So the opening is used to extract large image features. For example, here these small features in the input image are removed over here and only the larger features have remained, and we will also implement this in MATLAB. Also the same thing we saw in the previous video class, where these larger squares are extracted and these smaller squares are removed. So during erosion, all these squares are eroded out and the squares which were larger were remained, which were restored to their original size by using dilation. It is a combination of erosion and dilation. So first erosion was done over here and then dilation is done, which is called opening. Now if this is our image for which we want to carry out opening and this is the structuring element, then opening is erosion, then dilation will give opening. So erosion we will show with a blue pen. Say we keep the center of the structuring element over here, then the structuring element is fitting completely, and erosion says that the structuring element should fit completely, then only the center location will be kept as 1. So here the structure element is fitting completely, so this one will remain as 1. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, the structuring element is not fitting completely, right? So this one will not remain as 1. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, again the structuring element is fitting completely, so this one will also remain as 1 in the output image. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, again the structuring element is not fitting completely, so this one will not be selected. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, then again the structuring element is fitting completely, so this one will remain as 1. But if we keep the center of the structuring element over here, the structuring element is again not fitting completely. That means in the output image after erosion only these 3 ones will remain, which we also understood in the previous video class. Now we will carry out dilation, and dilation we will show with a red color, right? So now we have to concentrate only on these blue ones. Okay, others have become 0, right? Let us keep the center of the structuring element over here, then it is touching this one. For dilation it says that if minimum 1 pixel as 1 is touching, then the center of the structuring element will be made as 1. Okay, so if we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is already on the 1. Okay, so this will be selected as 1. Let us keep the center of the structuring element over here, then it is not touching this one. Okay, so this one will not be selected. Let us keep the center of the structuring element over here, then it is touching this one. So this will be selected, as well as this one will also be selected. This will be obviously selected. This will also be obviously selected. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is touching this one. So this will also be selected. Even this one will be selected, and this one will be selected. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, then it is touching this one, right? So this one will also be selected. And if we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is touching this one. So this one also will be made as 1. If we keep over here, this one will be selected because this is touching this one. This also is touching this one. This also is touching this one. And this also is touching this one. This one is also touching this one. But if we keep the center of the structuring element over here, then it is not touching any of the one. Okay, so this one will not be selected. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, okay, then it will not be touching this one. So this one will also not be selected, as well as this one also will not be selected. So after dilation, these ones will remain as 1 in the output image, and all others will be made 0. And we can see that opening has opened up this gap in the image. Now if this is the input image and this is our structuring element and we want to carry out opening, then first we will do erosion, then dilation, which will give us opening. Let us mark erosion with a blue color. So erosion says that the structuring element should fit completely inside the image, then only the pixel will be kept as 1. So this is our structuring element and this is the center of structuring element. So here it is fitting completely, and only for these locations the structuring element will be fitting completely. So after erosion, this will be the shape that will remain. Our next step is to carry out dilation, which we will denote with a red color. For dilation, it says that at least 1 pixel should touch the structuring element, then that particular pixel will be kept as 1. So now we have to keep this structuring element such that it touches at least 1 pixel. Okay, so this says the center of our structuring element, right? So at this location, at least 1 pixel will be touching. So center of the structuring element will be kept. Okay, so the same thing will be applicable for this location as well as other locations. So these are the centers of the structuring elements. So after dilation, this shape will remain, which is passing through the center of structuring elements. Okay, so first carrying out erosion, which is shown with a blue line, and then carrying out dilation, which is shown with a red line, opening or opened image will be like this. So this will be our opened image. So opening can be denoted as structuring element B rolling along the inner boundary of A. You can see here this B is rolling around the inner boundary. I hope it is clear. Now let us understand closing. Closing is just the opposite of opening. It is given by dilation and then erosion will give closing. The closing of set A by structuring element B is defined as A closing of B is equal to A dilation of B whole erosion of B. The closing operation fills holes that are smaller than the structuring element, joins narrow breaks, fills gaps in boundaries, and also smoothes objects' boundaries. So if this is our input image, then closing with a 10 cross 10 structuring element will fill this hole as well as this hole, as you can see here. So this figure also shows closing used for filling small holes in an image. So here there are small holes here as well as here, which are filled by closing, and this we will also implement in MATLAB. Now say we want to carry out closing for this image, then closing is dilation followed by erosion will give closing. So first dilation we will mark with a blue pen. This is our 3x3 square structuring element. Say we keep the center of our structuring element over here, so it will be touching this one. Okay, so this will become 1. So this will become 1. If we keep the structuring element or the center of the structuring element over here, it will be touching this one. So again this will become 1 as well as this will become 1. This will become 1 and this will also become 1. If we keep over here, it is touching these ones. So this also will become 1. This will become 1. If we keep the center of structuring element over here, it is touching this one. So this also will become 1. This also will become 1. Again, this will be touching this one. So this will become 1. This also will become 1. This will become 1. Why? Because it is touching this one, right? But if we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is not touching any 1. So this will remain as 0. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it will be touching this one. So this will become 1. But if we keep over here, it will not be touching any 1. So this will remain 0. If we keep over here, this will become 1 because it is touching this. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is touching this one. So this also will become 1. But if we keep the center of structuring element over here, it is not touching any 1. So this will remain 0. This also will remain 0. This will also remain 0, 0. That is dilation. Now we will carry out erosion, which we will show with a red color. So now these all circles are 1s and we have to fit this structuring element completely, right? If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is not fitting completely. Why? Because this is 0, right? So this will not be selected as 1. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, again it is not fitting completely due to this 0. If we keep over here, it is not fitting completely due to this 0. But if we keep over here, it is fitting completely because all these are 1s, right? So this will become 1 in the output image. Again, this will become 1. It is fitting completely. This will become 1. This also will become 1. This will become 1 because it is fitting completely. This also is fitting completely. So this also will become 1. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, it is not fitting completely. Why? Because this is 0, right? So this will remain 0. If we keep over here, this is 0. It will remain 0. If we keep over here, this will remain 0. If we keep the center of the structuring element over here, this will remain 0 because this is 0. Again, if we keep the center of the structuring element over here, this is 0. So it will remain 0. So after erosion, these red locations will become 1 and all other places will remain 0. Okay. So which is shown over here. Similarly, other structure after closing will become like this. Now for closing as opposed to opening, the structuring element B will be rolling on the outer boundary of set A. How? For closing, it is given by dilation followed by erosion will give closing C, right? Dilation we will show with a blue pen. So for dilation, we know that the structuring element should touch at least 1 pixel to consider the center of the structuring element as 1. So here it is touching 1 pixel. So this center will be now considered as 1 for dilation. Again, this will be the center. Next, we will perform erosion, which we will show with a red color. So for erosion, the structuring element should fit completely for the center of the structuring element to be considered as 1. If this is the shape now after dilation, for erosion, this structuring element, which is circle shaped, should fit completely inside. Okay, so it will be fitting completely inside like this. And after erosion, the shape which we will be obtaining will be like this, passing through the centers of the structuring element. So for closing, the structuring element B rolls on the outer boundary of set A. So after closing, this gap will be closed or this cone shaped will be removed. I hope it is clear. Let's go ahead. Now this opening and closing can be combined together for numerous applications. For example, here fingerprint enhancement is shown. We have a noisy image which contains undesirable noise over here that can be removed by using erosion, and this is the result of erosion where we can see that the noise is removed, but this eroded image is much smaller, so we perform dilation on it, which is called opening, right? So in this output image, the outer noise is removed but still the inner noise is present in the image, so we perform again the dilation of this image. And now after dilation, we can see that the image is much thicker. So we need to again perform erosion. So we perform erosion of this full. So this is erosion. So this is dilation followed by erosion, which is nothing but closing. So hence we combine both opening operation and closing operation to obtain our enhanced image. Now let us understand what happens when we carry out opening and closing for grayscale images. So if this is the original image, opening the grayscale image decreases the size of small bright details. As you can see here, these bright details are decreased with no appreciable effect on the darker gray levels. Whereas closing the grayscale image decreases the size of small dark details with relatively little effect on the bright features. So you can see here the small dark details which are present here and which were present here in the original image are decreased in the closed image. We'll perform this also in MATLAB. And this grayscale as well as color morphology has numerous applications such as morphological smoothing. As you can see here, that smoothing is obtained by performing a morphological opening followed by a closing. So if this is the original image, the smooth image is like this. One other application is morphological gradient, which can be used for edge detection. So morphological gradient is produced from subtracting an eroded image from the dilated version. Thus morphological gradient can be used for edge detection as shown here. Let us implement opening and closing in MATLAB. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.